You know, I've talked a lot about grains blocking zinc because of the anti-nutrient phytic acid, but did you know that nuts also have phytic acid and actually has quite a bit? Of course, most people consume more grains than they do nuts. But the anti-nutrient phytic acid has the ability to bind with zinc and block it from being absorbed in our bodies. It binds with iron, phosphorus, magnesium, calcium, chromium, copper, and manganese. So if you're consuming a lot of phytic acid, you can end up being deficient. Also, phytic acid inhibits certain enzymes that help you digest protein like pepsin and trypsin, also a starch enzyme called amylase. So these things are blocked. Now, let's say, for example, we had 100 grams of nuts. Brazil nuts take the lead with the most phytic acid. It has 1,790 milligrams of phytic acid. Then almonds with 1,400 milligrams. Then walnuts with 982 milligrams. Peanuts with 952 milligrams of phytic acid. And then we have hazelnuts with 648 milligrams of phytic acid. And so there's quite a bit of this anti-nutrient in nuts. So what you need to know is there are ways to reduce phytic acid. Number one, just not consume as much. Also realize that your own gut has certain microbes that can make the enzyme phytase that can break down phytic acid. Okay, so that's good. So you might not even have any issue with this at all. But if you germinate your nuts, that means you soak them overnight, dry them out, and consume them, you're going to reduce phytic acid. I talked about this in my book. Also, if you boil or pressure cook nuts, you're going to actually reduce the phytic acid. Now, realize this one point. In order for phytic acid to bind with zinc, it has to be in the same mixture. Okay, so let's say, for example, you start eating red meat or other foods, okay, and you start getting the benefit of zinc. Then you eat nuts after that, and so it's not exactly the same mixture, okay? You'll probably be somewhat okay because zinc has to be exposed or connected to phytic acid. Also, if you're including a lot more foods higher in zinc and a lot less foods lower in phytic acid, you're going to be in good shape. Like seafood, oysters are at the top of the list. Red meats, very, very high amounts of zinc, and fish have a good amount of zinc. So I just wanted to increase your awareness on other things that can deplete your zinc. And that's because zinc is a very, very important trace mineral.
Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself, and so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.